Hello dear students, we are discussing about index numbers. In the previous class, I gave you introduction of index numbers and we have seen unweighted index numbers. There are two kinds of index numbers, unweighted, weighted. Unweighted we have already seen, we have done problem also. Now today we are going to see weighted index numbers. Weighted index numbers, there are many index numbers. But today in this particular class, we'll be focusing only on Paschis, Laspiers and Fischers. These three will have a clear-cut idea. Before going to the suggestion, let me tell you, all the statistics related total concepts, link is given in the description box, first link only, please watch it. So whatever concepts you have missed, you can use it, and also other subjects, other concepts, links also there in the description box. Please watch it and try to watch it in the computer, desktop computer or laptop computer, so you'll have much clear idea. So anyway, let's enter into the problem. So today we are going to focus Laspiers, Paschis, Fischers. These three index numbers are very much famous and quite easy to understand, easy to remember the formulas also. Quickly let's go for the problem. Now here, Laspiers index. Laspiers index formula you have to remember. So the formula is sigma P1Q0 by P0Q0 into 100. Always remember P0Q0 means base year, current year. P0 means price of the current year. Q0 means quantity of current year. Are you getting it? So we are taking sigma P1Q0, sigma P0Q0. All zeros, only P1 is there. P0, Q0 into 100. So this is Laspiers index. Easy to remember. Next one, Paschis index. In Paschis index, P1Q1 by P0Q1 into 100. Now here everything is 1, 1, 1. Only this one downside, P0 is there. There, first one is P1. Here, P0. Rest of everything is there. All zeros, here all ones. Okay, so sigma P1 Q1 by sigma P0 Q1 into 100. This is Paschis, Laspiers Paschis. If you remember this, Fischers is just multiplication of this only. Fischers ideal index, this is very much famous, and you need to remember, you have to know how to calculate this. So now coming to the Fischers, Fischers ideal index. So the formula is P01 means Fischers. P01 is related to Laspiers, Paschis, Fischers. For everything, we'll say P01 only. So P01 is equal to sigma P1Q0 by P0Q0 into P1Q1 by P0Q1 into 100. See, P1Q0, P0Q0, this is the same one. The same one we are taking here means Laspiers into P1Q1 by P0Q1. So this is Paschis. See this? Paschis we are taking here into 100. Root of, but we are taking root of Laspiers and Paschis into 100. So in short, we can say it as a root of L and S into 100. Isn't it? So it's very easy to remember. Now let's go for one problem. So the problem is given to us, commodity A, B, C, D commodities are there. Base year, current year. Base year we have quantity, price. Base year means always we'll say zero. Quantity means Q0. Price P0. Current year, quantity Q1. Price P1. Are you getting it? 0 means base, 1 means current year. So this I have kept it like this solution. So up to here the problem is given up to here. Now coming to the solution, I have written the same one, commodity Q0, this one as it is, and P1 Q1. So this as it is I have written. Now as for the formula, what do we need? Formula is this, Laspiers. P1Q0
by P0, Q0. Means first we need P1, Q0. So P1, Q0 I have written. Means multiplication of P1 into Q0. That's it. Second one is P0, Q0 we need. So I have written P0, Q0. Multiplication of P0 into Q0. Next one, P1, Q1 we want. So P1, Q1 is written. Next P0, Q1. P0, Q1. This multiplication I have done already. Simple. If you see the problem, you will come to know what to calculate. Now as per the formula, we need all these four calculations. So what we have done? P1 into Q0. P1 is here. P1 into Q0. 12 12s are 144. 5 15s are 75. Like P1 Q0 is over. In the same way, P0 Q0. This P0 Q0. 12 10s are 120. Okay. 15 7s are 105. Like you got P0 Q0 also. In the same way, P1 Q1. Multiplication of these two. P1 Q1. 15 12s are 180. 25s are 100. Okay. Next, P0 Q1. P0 Q1. These two. 10 15s are 150. 7 20s are 140. Like you got P0 Q0 also. We have totaled everything. The totals are 505, 425, 530, 470. So this will say sigma P1 Q0 505, sigma P0 Q0 425, sigma P1 Q1 530, sigma P0 Q1 470. If this is done, the rest of the problem is simple. You have to implement it. Whatever we have done, the calculations, that has to be implemented into the formula. Now, so I have written first last year's index P01, same formula. Sigma P1 Q0 by sigma P0 Q0 into 100. Applying the same formula, P0 Q0 total is here 505. 505 by P0 Q0, 425 into 100. So we'll be getting 118.82. This is last years. In the same way, past years formula is sigma P1 Q1 by sigma P0 Q1. Sigma P1 Q1 by sigma P0 Q1. So sigma P1 Q1 total is here 530, right? And next, sigma P1 Q1 total is 470. If you multiply, you will be getting 112.77. So this is past years. Now coming to the Fisher's ideal index. Fisher's ideal index formula is saying, you know, as I told you, last year into past years. Last year into past years. Sorry, I have written yes. This is past years into 100. So we have applied it. Same, everything is we have implemented. So you are getting 115.76. That's it. Simple. This is Fisher's. Fisher's ideal index numbers. It will be useful even in the coming classes also. So let's see the coming classes, more problems, simple way and easy you can understand it. So let's be in touch. Please practice it. The more you practice, you'll have more confident on your subjects. Just go ahead, see the description box, more problems, more information is there. So just practice well. Wish you good luck. Exams are very much near. Take care.